We're going to take a look at chase effects. Chase effects are designed to be created, edited until you're happy, and then to never change again. So they're designed to be set up and played back over and over again in the same exact way every time. A chase effect is traditionally a blinky intensity effect. It could also be a rippling intensity effect. They're really good for very random intensity, chases, water reflections, lightning, television flickers, fire, and so on. So let's get started. And the first thing we're going to do in many cases is think, I want to make a chase of these particular lights. And in this case, you can in fact start by selecting some lights. In this case, I've selected 6 lights in the middle of my rig. I'll turn them on so you can see where they're at. I'll turn them off again. So in my work process, I'm going to think, I want to make these 6 lights chase. The way I can do that very simply is now to say insert effect. So I press and hold insert, and I hit the effect key, and I let go. And this is how we insert effect playbacks of all types into our show file. The first one, though, is the chase effect, and it includes a bit of extra information at the bottom of the wizard. This lets us say, I want to chase these 6 lights, so I'm going to insert a new chase effect playback, and I'm going to create the chase object that the playback will play back at the same time. So I'm going to tick the little box that says, create a chase from these selected channels. I'm going to give the chase a name that will recognize, something short and sweet, called Bob. And I have 6 lights selected, so it's assumed that I want to make 6 steps in my chase, 1 light per step. I'm going to change this up a little bit and use 3 steps so that we can talk about distribution. Distribution lets me choose how these 6 lights are going to be distributed across these 3 steps. So we know pretty much we're going to get 2 lights per step because 6 divided by 3 is 2. And then I get to choose in this drop-down menu exactly what that math is going to be. Sequential is going to group them, in this case, the first 2 lights together, the second 2 lights together, and the third 2 lights together. Interlaced will be the first and the fourth, second and fifth, third and sixth. Symmetrical is the first and sixth, second and fifth, third and fourth. So I get more of this outside in or inside out type of behavior, depending on the order of my channel selection. Then I have 3 inverted versions of the same math, which will simply take my channel selection and invert it as if I had selected the channels backwards. Then there's 2 randoms. There's a random, which we call artist random, and there's true random, which I call engineer random. In artist random, I have 3 steps, I have 6 lights. I want 2 lights per step, but I want a random 2 lights per step. In true random, this is organic, engineer, really, really random. So in our case here, it could mean that my result will be the first step has 1 light, the second step has no lights, and the third step has 5 lights, because that's really, really random. That's good for water reflections and lightning and fire and things that you want to look more organic. This random, artist random, is more when you're trying to just make a random looking effect for music and that sort of thing. We're going to keep it simple for the moment and keep it in sequential distribution. Now, when I hit the execute key, 3 things are going to happen. We're going to insert a chase effect playback, number 2. We're going to select that chase effect playback. So all I have to do is bring intensity up, and that chase will start running. And the third thing that's going to happen is the system's going to create this chase object called Bob using the distribution and all the default settings to get us started. So I'll hit execute. You can see my effect 2 is now selected in live. I'll roll up the intensity, and our chase called Bob is going to start running. In my device controls dock, you can see the 2 parameters that chase effect playbacks have. What chase am I running? And how fast should it run? The rate tap function is kind of interesting because you can see our default is a 1 second step. And the lights snap on, stay on for 1 second, and then snap off. So that's what we're seeing in visualization here. If I want to match music, I can just tap on the tap function, and now that chase will speed up or slow down and match the tempo that I've tapped in. If I take that back to 100, it goes back to the recorded levels.